guys, how you doing? Welcome back to my channel, it's Clarice. This is gonna be my very first DIY fall video. And you know what, I'm extremely excited for the season because not only is this one of my favorite time of the year, but somehow I just love, love, love doing DIYs for the fall. So I hope that you enjoy this one that I'm gonna be sharing with you. This is strictly Dollar Tree products, well, except for maybe one thing, but this is super affordable and something that you can all do and customize yourself. So I hope that you enjoy this product and let's get to it. Obviously, we're hitting up the Dollar Tree for some fall decor. This is also where we are gonna get our mats just like these ones. I got both of these colors and the only thing I did was turn them around, take off that sticker, and they're all ready to go. I just still can't believe that this is going to be such a cheap project. So we're also going to be needing a flat, medium-sized paintbrush just like this one. And we're going to need some acrylic paints. Use the outdoor one. These are the patio paints you get from Michaels. You need this because obviously you're going to be stepping on this a lot and you're not going to want the paint to peel off. There's many of these felt fall decors that you can pick from. There's acorns and there's like a bunch of leaves and all that other stuff, but I really like this pumpkin one. So we're just gonna tape this to secure it down and then we're gonna take our paint and we're just gonna dab the paint onto the actual mat here, just like how you see it. And we're dabbing this one and doing this technique because we wanna prevent it from just bleeding onto the doormat. And so what you wanna do is just take your flat brush and you wanna make it even flatter when you put on a little bit of the paint, just like this, so make it as thin as possible. And this is really important when you're trying to do the sides just like this, because you want it to be really thin and you don't want it to go all over the mat. So you actually wanna try and use a thinner brush if you're more comfortable to do that. So what you're gonna do is you're just gonna go all over and trace it all around just like this. And if it's a little bit too light for you, you can dab on another coat and it's gonna look just like this. It felt like it was missing a little bit of something something, so I had to add a little bit of a border. And I just did that with a permanent marker, and you can go over this with the outdoor acrylic paint, but I'm just gonna leave it as is because I think it's gonna work out. For our next doormat design, I got this doily. Doily, is that how you pronounce it? I have no idea, but anyways, I got these doilies from the dollar store as well as these stencils that we are gonna be using. And this is super easy, just like the first one. We're just gonna place this where we want the flowers to come out and we're gonna be using the outdoor white acrylic paint to do this. Very similar technique like before, we're just gonna dab it on. And you especially have to be really careful with this one because there's actually really tiny holes where the doily is, and that's gonna go on the mat. But the more you're careful, then the more precise it's gonna look and the more clean it's gonna turn out. After it dries, you're gonna wanna put a second coat on so that it's darker, and look how they turn out, just absolutely beautiful. And of course, we're gonna put a sign or we're gonna put something else on this. We're using the stencil that we got from the dollar store. I'm using this masking tape as a guide and I'm also spacing the letters out evenly because, you know, I'm crazy like that, but if you just wanna kinda eyeball it, that's totally up to you. And so you can begin on putting or painting on the letters that you want on there. We're gonna put Hello Pumpkin because of course it's fall and it's kind of cute. Again, you can customize this DIY to whatever you want it to be. It could be for any occasions. You can even change your doormat like every single month if you have some kind of event. I absolutely love it and this is just a great way to welcome the new season. How this turned out, and I hope that you are too. Let me know in the comments down below what you think of this DIY or if you're gonna be recreating it. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also my vlog channel for more fun DIYs, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye.